Hey everyone, it's Mercedes, back from the virtual roadshow, again to follow up on the Petal paint experiment that I did about a week ago. I took some time to come up with a better way to organize my table and test out all of the colors again. As you can see really well in this setup, the paints that have gum arabic in them look shiny and have a glossy finish, while the ones without gum arabic dried out to be more matte. To make sure that these watercolors are actually usable, I'm putting them to the test by painting some loose watercolor roses. I am testing them out on cold-pressed watercolor paper and using a size 4 round brush. If anyone else decides to make some petal paints, I would love to see what you create with it also. One of my favorite parts about being an artist and a scientist is sharing it with other people and having other people share theirs with me as well. It's such a great way to get to know someone or even a great way to learn some really cool science.
Okay, so I was writing down observations as we went through the experiment and recorded them all the way up until just before I was getting ready to paint with them. And now I'm going to record some observations I have after painting. Thank you.
So there you have it. And to finish up, now we just X out our unused space.